you have to do interviews, you have to call around and like search for inspiration, like high and low. That's like the point of the course.
It's not about the product, it's about the concept of the product. Us developing a prototype was more of showcasing the idea rather than making a good prototype, because IKEA is going to develop them themselves.
In the fall, I taught for the first time a course called Digitalization and AI in Practice in the Software Engineering Master's Program. And the idea was to really work together with industry to create that bridge between industry and education.
The course is more about helping computer science students like myself, who are studying, building, how to build technologies, new software, helping them to come up with ideas that solve companies, like real world companies' problems. So we collaborated with IKEA.
It was fun, to say the least, because IKEA is a big company and it's not like a startup company. So we felt like if we bring something of value to IKEA here, it's something both beneficial to us and to IKEA, of course.
It was quite a pleasant surprise. I've been to IKEA like several times as a child, as a young adult, so on and so forth. So it's fun to like actually do something with a big brand, a brand that's really well known here in Sweden and also worldwide.
The students were very kind of apprehensive in the beginning, because the whole point of the assignment was not to have a very clear goal. It was, the objective was to create a digital innovation, which was difficult for them. It's very different from just saying, we are going to study, you know, this topic and you will have an exam and here's last year's questions and this is what you need to get a grade 5.
Like in the beginning, it was quite vague what we were going to do or what we were going to try to deliver.
We were mostly brainstorming and talking and kind of having our own different opinions on what to do and what not to do. Start off, we couldn't really get our footing on. We couldn't straight on go to programming or developing something because we didn't quite know what.
That's the point of the course, because when you get out in real life and working for industry and companies or yourself, you are presented with challenges and you don't know where to start. So it's all about that problem-solving capacity. So as the course went on, they started understanding more and more the value of the course. But it's difficult for them in many ways, because it's a new approach to education and to learning.
Well, specifically, we had the area kitchen planners. So we found our inspiration at IKEA. So our research mainly consisted of doing interviews and like talking to the actual kitchen planners, like what are you experiencing? How are you being hindered in your workflow? And then with all of these data combined, we just sat down and brainstorming.
So our project was in the focus of trying to streamline communication between, say, upper-up in the company towards the employees. So idea was to build a knowledge base, which IKEA already has, so we didn't want to kind of, you know, redo the wheel, but we tried to find what is the issue with the current one, what are issues, possible issues, and what can we develop further on it. So our product became a knowledge base, web-based knowledge base, and it had some nice features for customizability. So you can modify it to your personal needs. And that was something we kind of liked, because then employees can adjust it to or tailor it to their needs. Along with that, we also developed a prototype for a forum, and that one we liked. And I believe IKEA liked that one as well. So the forum is kind of a way for employees to ask questions and have other employees answer the questions, so they together can spread the knowledge amongst themselves.
In order to be successful and in the future, you have to communicate your idea in front of people you don't know. So I did pressure them to actually do this, which some students did not like. They are not used to that. Others really liked it. But I mean, if I think back to when I was their age, I was terrified to stand on stage. But it is something that you learn, and you can learn. But you have to be provided the opportunities to learn that, and in a safe environment.
The presentation went, it went well. We were quite well prepared. Yeah, sure, it was quite shaky doing something in person to IKEA employees.
Not that we expected to have some stage fright, but as when you're in the moment, then we kind of hiccuped up. But the spokespersons or the contacts from IKEA that were there, they were understanding.
I know that most Swiss are shy to stand in front of a group of people and talk and then give their presentation. I think this course gives them the opportunity to try it. Also, being in the university environment is like a psychological safety. This is the place to make all your mistakes.
So we won our challenge. It was really good, actually, yeah, because we spent a lot of time both doing the research and also making sure that our prototype was interactive and easy to follow. And also, I think we did a great job in like presenting our ideas and our prototype.
What I really enjoyed was when the students really engaged. When they came and they came to the coaching sessions, they wanted to talk with me about their ideas, and they really understood the value of interaction and communication instead of like running too far and, oh, what have we been doing? Instead, really working through, coming to the coaching sessions, talking with me about their idea, getting feedback. That I think is, you know, that was what I really enjoyed the most.
We had our disagreements. Or I had my disagreements, perhaps, but I mean, we got through. We always were able to continue on with the project.
And yeah, sure, we had our disagreements, but still, it's easier to come forward with your disagreement because we actually know each other since before. So I think that was a great strength.
If there's one thing that we're really good to do, and that's just chit chat. So we could be more productive.
Yeah.
100% we could be.
Yeah.
But then we wouldn't have as much fun, though.
I mean, that's part of it.
At the end of the course, they can say that they've created a digital innovation. And for the winners of the challenge, they have the ability to put that on their CV, that they were the winner of a, you know, digital innovation challenge for IKEA and have come up with a digital innovation. So my whole this purpose here is, how can I enable the students to be much more hireable or, you know, yeah, employable, either for themselves or for another organization?
Oh, I want to stay in IT or information technology sector. That's obvious, of course. But right now, I'm leaning towards cybersecurity. It feels like a ever-growing sector, and it sounds fun.
Hopefully, something around the area of cybersecurity or software architecture. I think. Well, software architecture is, how is everything going to communicate internally? Like all of the components, all the technological components, which the users and people from the outside don't see.
After I graduate, I would want to work with something that would be beneficial for humankind, the planet, while also having the freedom to snowboard or surf.